Good morning to all of you. Now I'm going to continue chapter that is game playing and the last concept remaining that is alpha beta pruning. Now alpha and beta, these are nothing but these are the values, and alpha beta pruning is the advanced version of the min max algorithm. Already we have seen min max algorithm. We have seen how we can make the design for two players or multiplayer games in case of artificial intelligence. Now here, this is the advanced version of min-max algorithm. Now here, max is nothing but alpha and min is nothing but beta. So alpha and beta, these are the values, and pruning means we have to cut down the values. Now what values we have to cut down? Once we got one optimal path, then the remaining path we have to cut down, or we have to remove the path. सध्या आपण अल्फा बीटा प्रोनिंग ह्या कॉन्सेप्टवरती कॉन्सन्ट्रेट करतोय. तर अल्फा बीटा ॲक्च्युली काय आहेत? तर अल्फा आणि बीटा ह्या दोन व्हॅल्यूज आहेत. अल्फा ही व्हॅल्यू असणार आहे, तर अल्फा व्हॅल्यू मॅक्स व्हॅल्यू असणार आहे, आणि बीटा व्हॅल्यू ही मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू असणार आहे, मीन व्हॅल्यू असणार आहे. जेव्हा आपल्याला ट्री डिझाईन करतोय आपण, समजा एखादा गेम ट्री असणार आहे, आणि त्या गेम ट्रीसाठी आपण ज्यावेळा आपण डिझाईन करतोय तेव्हा मल्टिपल वेज असणार आहेत. तर मल्टिपल वेजपैकी आपण एक ऑप्टिमल पाथ किंवा बेस्ट पाथ आपण फाइंड आउट करतो. सो म्हणजे सपोज देर इज वन सोर्स अँड देर इज वन टार्गेट. आता सोर्सपासून टार्गेटकडे जाण्यासाठी तुम्हाला मल्टिपल वेज असू शकतील गेम ट्रीमध्ये, पण मल्टिपल वेजपैकी कोणता तरी एक पाथ हा बेस्ट पाथ असणार आहे. मग समजा आपल्याला जर बेस्ट पाथ जर मिळाला, तर जे रिमेनिंग पाथ आहेत ते रिमेनिंग पाथ आपल्याला रिमूव्ह करायचे किंवा कटडाऊन करायचे. तर ते कटडाऊन म्हणजे प्रोनिंग. So alpha, it is a minimum alpha, that is it is a maximum value, and beta, that is minimum value. So out of this minimum and maximum values, we have to find out the best path, and out of this best path we have to remove the remaining path, and that is alpha beta pruning. When pruning is applied to standard min max tree, it returns the same move as minimax would, but prunes always branches that cannot possibly influence the final decision. It means that once we got optimal decisions, we can remove the other branches, because other branches that are not possibly influence the final decision. So that will be have to take into consideration that ज्या काय पॉसिबल वेज असतील किंवा ज्या काय पॉसिबल ब्रँचेस असतील त्यापैकी जर आपल्याला बेस्ट फाइंड आउट झाला, तर बाकीच्या ब्रँचेस ह्या कुठल्याही डिसिजन्समध्ये इन्फ्लुएन्स नाही करणार. सो फायनल डिसिजन्समध्ये बाकीच्या वेज किंवा बाकीचे रूट्स इन्फ्लुएन्स नाही करणार. त्याच्यामुळं वी हॅव टू रिमूव्ह द रिमेनिंग ब्रँचेस. नाउ लेट्स गो थ्रू द कॅल्क्युलेशन ऑफ द ऑप्टिमल डिसिजन्स वन्स मोर. दिस टाइम paying careful attention to what we know at each point in the process. The steps explained are in the figure. So in the latter figure we are going to see also how it is going to display it. The outcome is that we can identify the min-max decision without ever evaluating the two of the leaf nodes. So we have to calculate the leaf nodes also, and depending on the value of the leaf nodes we have to calculate min value and max value. Now another way to look at this is the simplification of the formula min-max. Now let us two unevaluated successor of the node C in the figure have the values of x and y. Then the value of the root node is given by, this will be the formula to calculate min-max of the root. Now here we have to calculate max value, but these are the leaves. So out of these three leaves we have to calculate max value, but every leaf have three values, and out of these three values we have to calculate min value. म्हणजे एखाद्या रूटचं मला जर मिनिमॅक्स व्हॅल्यू फाइंड आउट करायची असेल, तर मला मॅक्सिमम व्हॅल्यू त्या रूटची फाइंड आउट करायची आहे. तर त्या रूटला तीन लीफ असणार आहेत किंवा तीन लीफ नोड असणार आहेत. ह्या तीन लीफ नोड्सपैकी मला मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू फाइंड आउट करायची आहे. सो ह्या तीनपैकी ह्या 3, 12 आणि 8 ह्या तीनपैकी मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू इज 3. सो आय एम टेकिंग 3 व्हॅल्यू फर्स्ट. आउट ऑफ दिस आय डोंट नो व्हॅल्यू ऑफ एक्स अँड वाय. सो आय एम किपिंग ऑल दिस 3 व्हॅल्यूज ॲज इट इज. सो मीन ऑफ 2 कॉमा एक्स अँड वाय. नाव आउट ऑफ दिस 14, 5 अँड 2 द मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू इज 2. सो आय एम टेकिंग 2 ॲज अ मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू. सो मीन ऑफ 14, 5 अँड 2 मीन्स आय हॅव टू टेक मिनिमम व्हॅल्यू आउट ऑफ दिस 3 व्हॅल्यूज. So like this, in the first step, I have taken three values. Now, I have to calculate the max value. Now here, I want minimum of 2, x and y. So here I can think that if I place z for all these values, then z will be minimum of 2, x and y, such a way that it should be less than or equal to 2. That means the minimum value out of this will be 2. So if I am taking the minimum value as a 2, then I want to calculate the maximum value. So the z can be 2 or less than 2. So here I want to calculate the maximum value of all of these 3. Out of these 3, the maximum value will be 3. So like this, I can calculate the maximum value for that particular node. Now this is the tree where I have to calculate the min value and the max value. Now we will take one by one. Now for this diagram, now this is root A. For root A, minimum, that is the values will be, min max values will be from infinity to infinity, means from minus infinity to plus infinity. Now I am taking first node. For the B node, I don't know the value, starting value, so it will be minus infinity. That means I don't have the minus value, but for this node I have the single value, that is will be 3. So here the value will be 3. Now I am taking next tree. Now here for this node I have infinity values, because the value is not yet calculated. Now for this node, the value will be, I want a minimum value out of these nodes. So obviously the minimum value is 3, so I am taking 3 as a minimum value. Now for this tree, I have to calculate the value. Okay, so the value, so for this tree, we have to calculate the minimum value, that will be the 3. So I got two values, that is the minimum value, that is 3 and 3. So out of this I can place 3 value for the root node. Now here also we have to calculate the minimum value. So like this, we have to calculate the minimum value for each node. So out of this, the minimum value will be 3 and 3. For this, the minimum value will be the 2, and here the minimum value will be 14. Now out of this, we have to calculate the minimum value. So like this, we have to calculate min value and max value. So now this will be the root and these are the nodes. So the formula we have to take into consideration is, so at every node and at every tree, at every node we have to apply this formula, and according to this formula we have to calculate the values. So that formula is applied over here, and out of this we have to calculate the minimum value and maximum value, the value of the root, and hence the minimax decision are independent of the values of the pruned values x and y. Alpha beta pruning can be applied to trees of any depth. So the benefit of this algorithm is that we can apply it at any depth, and it is often possible to prune entire subtrees rather than just values. The general principle is that consider node n somewhere in the tree, such that the player has a choice of moving to that node. If the player has a better choice m, either at the parent node of n or at any choice point further up, then n will never be reached in actual play. So once we have found that enough about n to reach this conclusion, we can prune it. That means if the player has a better choice m, either at a parent node of n, means the player has a better choice out of the parent, then the choices which are lesser important, that can be cut off, or that can be pruned. That means we can take the optimal decisions, and the remaining decisions we can prune it. The min-max search is the depth first. So at any one time, we just have to consider the nodes along a single path in the tree. Alpha beta pruning gets its name from the following two parameters that describe the bounds on the backed up values that appear anywhere along the path. So alpha and beta, these are the two values. Now the alpha value is what? Alpha value is the value of the best, that is the highest value. Alpha is the highest value. choice we can found out so far at any choice point along the path max. So alpha is the maximum value and beta obviously it is a minimum value, the value of the best, that is lowest. Alpha is the highest best value and beta is the lowest best value. Alpha beta search updates the values of alpha and beta so as it goes along the end prune remaining branches at a node. As soon as the leaves of the current node is known to be worse than the current alpha or beta value for min or max respectively. That means alpha and beta values are updates every time and what are the prune values that will be removed or that will be cut off. Now we'll check how the move ordering is done or how in what way the moving of the nodes will be done. The effectiveness of alpha and beta pruning is highly dependent on the order in which the states are examined. Means how the states are examined, it depends on that. For example, in figure, in the last figure from the E and F, we could not prune any successor of D at all because the worst successor were generated first. If the third successor of D has been generated first, we would have been able to prune the other two. He suggests that it might be worthwhile to try to examine the first successor that are likely to be best. So the ordering is very important because it may happen that we have taken the example of the previous one from the figure E and F. We can conclude that we could not prune any successor of D at all because the worst successor were generated first. It means the worst successor was generated first. So we cannot prune it. We cannot prune it means we cannot remove it. So if the third successor of the D has been generated first, we would have been pruned the other two. It means the first two successor were not, or the first two path were not optimal, but the third is optimal. But the third is not generated first. So if the third successor of the D has been generated first, then we would have been able to prune the other two. Now this suggests that it might be worthwhile to try to examine the first successor that are likely to be the best. So it may happen that the first successor can be a best, but it does not the case always, because in the last figure of E and F it has been seen that the first two successor or first two steps were not the optimal, but the third step is optimal. But we may assume that the first is really optimal, but it is not the case. If this can be done, then it turns out that alpha beta needs to examine only order of b raised to m by 2 nodes to pick up the best move instead of order of b raised to m for min max. This means that the effective branching factor becomes square root of b instead of b for chess, about 6 instead of 35. Now put another way, alpha beta can solve a tree roughly twice as deep as minimax in the same amount of time. If the successor are examined in random order than the best first, the total number of nodes examined will be roughly optimum of b into bs. If the successors are examined in random order than the best first, the total number of nodes examined will be roughly order of b raised to 3m divided by 4 for moderate b. For chess, a fairly simply ordering function gets you to within about a factor of 2 of the best case order of b raised to m by 2 results. So that will be the optimum decisions, means how the optimum decision can be taken. So these are the equations where the optimum decisions can be taken. So it may happen that the first order, the first decision may not be the optimal, or second decision may not be optimal. So if we work in that way, then the total number of nodes examined will be roughly at this time complexity for the moderate b's. That means the time complexity will be order of b raised to 3m divided by 4. Now this will be the algorithm for the functions. So the functions alpha beta search, we are sending the state and it is going to return an action. So what will be the action or what will be the output? That depends on the max value of the state infinity and infinity. So we are passing state, we are passing initial values. So initially minus values and plus values, it is going to return an action in action states with a value of new. For max value, it is going to calculate the max value. For the min value, it is going to calculate the min value. So already we have seen this equation also. Now the dynamic adding dynamic move ordering scheme, such as trying first the moves that were found to be the best in the past, brings up quite close to the theoretical limit. That means it has a theoretical limit that we cannot prove which is the best or the first move will be the best. So out of these moves, we have to calculate the optimal, but we cannot say that first will be the best move. The past could be the previous move, often the same threads remain, or it could be come from the previous exploration of the current move. One way to gain the information from the current move is with the iterative depending search. It means there should be iteration from one step to another, such a way that we are going to give the optimal decision. First search, first player dip and record the best path of move, then the search first player deeper but use the recorded path to inform the move ordering. So the player 1, it is going to search the best path and it is going to record the best path. Now then in the next move, it is going to search up deeper and use the recorded path which was previously to inform the move ordering. So how the ordering will be done, it depends on the what recorded previously from the path. In many games, repeated states occur frequently because of transposition. That means transposition is nothing but different permutations or different combinations of the move sequence that end up with the same position. So in case of game playing, there can be different positions or there can be different moves, and that is called as transposition, different positions. So there can be possibility or there can be different permutations. So we have to take that permutation into consideration. For example, if white has one move A1 that can be answered by black with B1 and unrelated move A2 on the other side of the board that can be answered by B2, then the sequence will be A1, B1, A2, B2 and A2, B2, A1, B1 both end up in the same position. It means that if there are two players, that's white and black. Now if white has answered, means white has done one move, that move is called A1, and that move is replied by B1, and B1 is a move by a black player. Now an unrelated move, that is A2, A2 is not related to any player, that's unrelated move A2 on the other side of the board can be answered by B2. That means for move A1 that can be answered by B1, in the similar fashion for A2 that can be answered by B2. So the sequence will be A1, B1, A2, B2, and sequence will be A2, B2, A1, B1. So both and that both will be on the same position. So it is worthwhile to store the evaluation of the resulting position in the hash table first time it is encountered, so that it won't have to recompute it on the subsequent occurrences. So these all sequences will be stored in the hash values. The hash table of previously seen positions is traditionally called as transposition table. So the previous moves by A and B players or by black and white players that can be stored in the hash table, and that hash table is called as transposition table. It is essentially identical to be explored it in a graph search. Using a transposition table can have a dramatic effect, sometimes as much as doubling the reachable search depth in the chess. On the other hand, if we are evaluating a millions of nodes per second, at some point it is not a practical to keep all of them in the transposition table. So if we are trying to evaluate each and every node, then it is not possible to keep it in a hashing table or in a transposition table. So various strategies we have to apply in that situation or in that critical situation where we have to store the millions of nodes. So it is not possible to evaluate the millions of nodes per second, and that's why we have to specify the different strategies also for particular nodes and remaining which have to discard. So that was the alpha beta pruning. In case of alpha beta pruning, we have to just calculate min and max. So that was in a quite depth, that was a quite depth session. So that much depth is not related as required as per your syllabus. So just keep in mind that how the alpha beta pruning is happen. So we have to calculate min value, we have to calculate max value, and we have to assign that value to a node. So that much you have to keep in mind. Second thing about the transposition table, we have to get the hashed values, and that is we want to store in the transposition table. So that was end of the session. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.